your rake, get the word of God, and look into your heart. I hear God said in one place, guard your heart with all diligence, for out of your heart proceeds the issues of life. Listen, ain't nobody living that ain't got no issues, but everybody needs to rake over your own heart and rake up those distractions, rake up every last one of those excuses, those little light things, rake up those convenient things, and put them in the barrel, and take the barrel out on trash day. Take the barrel out and push it out front and let them come get it. I don't want to see that mess no more. You need a rake to rake your heart. Yes, you do. And the word of God is a good rake. But then there's some, glory, hallelujah, there's some that has an attitude. There's some that got some rough exterior and interior, and you can't tell me nothing. And I've been like this all of my life, yet I'm saved. I'm sanctified. I'm filled with the Holy Ghost, but I ain't doing that, and I ain't doing this. Sound like you got some rocks in your heart. Sound like you got some stuff that a rake just won't do. You mess around and break up. Now, this ain't no leafy stuff. This some heart entrenched stuff. So, Lord, have mercy. You need a hole then. Glory. Hallelujah. You need a hole to dig in and pull up them rocks. Some of us are too stubborn. Some of us are sitting on the gifts that God has given us. We done let some rocks of resentment, let some rocks of anger, let some rocks of jealousy get all in our hearts. And here God said, I've gifted you. I've blessed you. You can be a blessing to the house of God. You can be a blessing to the body of Christ. But yet and still, there's too many rocks in your heart. I hear God say, you need a hoe. Glory. Hallelujah. And you need a good hoe. Hallelujah. To dig up them rocks. And sometimes you got to put your back into it and get them rocks up out of your heart. There's some people sitting here right now today. You need a hoe. Yes, you do. Not a whore. You need a hoe. You hear what I said? You need a gardening tool to rake over and turn up some of them rocks. Because sometimes those rocks have been in our heart for so long. You turn them over, you're going to find all kind of bugs underneath the rocks. Glory. Hallelujah. God said, get them bugs out of there. You need some fertilizer. What you need? God said, I've given you an internal fertilizer in the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Ghost will kill out all them bugs that are underneath the rocks in your heart. God said, get to work on your own heart. Put a gate up around your heart. He told you to guard it. Now get to work. Dig up them rocks and get them rocks and put it in the barrel. Lord have mercy. Some of y'all, a rake won't do. Y'all need a hoe to get them rocks up out of your heart. Glory. Hallelujah. Then, Lord have mercy. Then there's a group, believe it or not, I'm almost finished. Glory. Hallelujah. Then there's some. Glory. Hallelujah. A rake won't do. No, and even a good hoe won't do you no good. But you need a shovel. Why? Because you got some stuff that's stinking in your heart. You got some stuff that's trenched down to the root of your heart. You were like that before you got saved, and still there's all kind of symptoms. God said you need a shovel. You got to dig up some of that stuff that's smelling the aroma of your personality, the aroma of your disposition. You're supposed to be sweetly saved, not sourly saved, but there's some stuff in your heart that got you stinking. Nobody likes to be around you. Always an argument, always got a complaint. God said you need a shovel to dig up some of that stuff. dig it up and put it in the barrel. And then there's some that need a shovel to bury some stuff. Glory. Hallelujah. What we used to do. Bury that stuff. We ain't like what we... Listen, if you continue to be like what you used to do, that means you're not growing. So God said, get your shovel. It's the word of God. And bury some of that traditional stuff. Glory. Hallelujah. Bury that stuff that didn't work no way, but because you thought it up or somebody in your family thought it up, you figure I'm going to hold on to it for dear life, but it's stinking now. It's messing up your heart. It's stopping you from going out and doing the work of God. Listen, I got to put a plug in for the soup over here on the table. Listen, this table should be running over. You hear what I said? It should be running over. Because there's hungry people. We see some of them every month. There's hungry people all in our neighborhood. But some of us got too many leaves and too many rocks and too many.
Pastor.
And see, the enemy don't want you to be cultivated. The enemy don't want you to be distracted. All that was a leaf. Glory. Hallelujah. But I'm so glad God told me to get my tools. So when the leaf comes, I can go back. So you got to know where your tools are. I can go back and get the rake and pull that leaf to the side and don't let it distract me. Sometimes we lose the victory over little leaves. Glory. But I got some rocks to dig up. I can't let a leaf trip me up. I hear the Bible said it's the little foxes that destroy the vine. I ain't got time to trip over no leaf. I ain't got time to stumble over no rock. So I'm going to use my rake. I'm going to use my hoe. And I'm going to use my shovel. Because there's some stuff. Oh, God. Whew. I got two pit bulls at the house, and they got full reign of the backyard and the house, and I've trained them, thank God, to go to the bathroom outside. Glory. Hallelujah. So they don't have to go in the house. But if I never go out there with a shovel and pick up what they dropped off, my whole backyard will be smelling like a cesspool. Sometimes we are guilty of letting other folks deposit some stinking stuff into our hearts. Did you hear what I said? You're going by what so-and-so said. I don't like her because she did that. She ain't did nothing to you. That's your sister and that's your brother. Stop, stop letting somebody defecate in your heart toward your brother and your sister. Anytime they want to stop with an upset stomach and defecate in your heart, run. I said run and get your shovel. Oh, God, I'm going to be a little graphic here. Get it while it's still smoking. Glory, hallelujah, and dig it up. Don't only dig that up, dig the dirt that is sitting on up. Because you don't want a memory of that smell. Dig it up and put it in the barrel. You can't not allow somebody to defecate and drop off some garbage in your heart. We got too much work to do for God. We got too much territory to take for God. Too many people are dying and going to hell for us to get hung up on our heart condition. I hear God say, you got a rake, you got a hoe, you got a shovel, you got the fertilizer of the Holy Ghost. And when you get your heart right, God said, I'll speak to the very elements. I'll speak to the environment. And I'll cause the clouds to bump into each other and pour down a rain. God said, I want to send a ladder rain, but I don't want to rain on no leaves. I don't want to rain on no rocks. I don't want to rain on no refuge. God said, clean it up. And I want to rain a ladder rain on you. So today, and every day going forward, use your rake, use your hoe, and use your shovel. And then, and only then, will you be able to do like it said in the last part of that parable, that it fell on good ground. Good ground, you want good ground in your heart. You need a rake, you need a hoe, and you need a shovel. If you ain't got that, you ain't got good ground. I need a rake. I need a hoe. And Lord knows I need a shovel. Use your rake. Use your hoe. Use your shovel. And then you won't be unbroken. You'll be broken. Your heart will be cultivated. You'll be ready to do the work of God. I'm going to stop. A rake, a hoe, and a shovel. What are we going to do with that? What are we going to do with that? What are we going to do with that? That's my question. What are we going to do with it? What ground did this word fall on this morning? What ground did it fall on? Did it fall by the wayside? Well, I'm going to dismiss that. Did it fall in stony places? It sounded good, but because you're not firmly grounded, you endure for a little while. But then when persecution comes because of that very same word, because you're not rooted, you don't last. Did the word fall into a place that was cluttered with the desire for riches, and it choked out the very word, make it unprofitable? Not even the first crop that came up, because you're worried about riches, you're worried about your material possessions. Or did it fall on good ground? Now the answer will be manifested in your life. And remember the overarching scripture: we beheld the glory. We will be able, not only we, but everybody will be able to behold the glory of God in a heart that's been cultivated by use of a rake, a hoe, and a shovel. That's what God gave me, and that's what I delivered. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If you're here this morning and you've never repented of your sins, you've never accepted the fact that you were born in sin and shapen in iniquity, you never realize or take an advantage of the fact that Jesus paid the price for your sin on the cross of Calvary, and you don't have to die an enemy of God. The Bible said God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Yes. God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him, the world through Jesus, might be saved.
If you've never been saved, if you never repented, never changed your heart, changed your mind, changed the direction of your life, we are inviting you to give your life to the sower of the seed, and the sower is God. Give your life to Jesus while you have time. Because there is going to be a day when it's going to be the last day. And we don't know when your individual last day is, but before your last day comes, we would encourage you and admonish you to give your life to Jesus. Are you here? Are you here this morning and say, yeah, I want to be saved? If that's you, come now. Come now. It doesn't take long for you to make up your mind. You're a very intelligent individual, and you know whether you're saved or not. But we just want to bring this invitation to you at every opportunity we get to make the call for salvation first. Are you here? Once you repent, we will baptize you in water in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. And God has promised to give you the gift of the Holy Ghost. And you can begin to work on your garden, the garden of your heart. Now maybe you're here this morning and you see the condition of your heart. Saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. Not questioning that, but you see the condition of your heart. And you see that you haven't been using your rake. You haven't been using your hoe. You haven't been using your shovel. But you need to make a personal commitment by coming forward and letting these ministers pray with you that you will do the work and allow God's Spirit to work with you and cultivate your own heart so your heart can be open to God, so that God can bring forth and manifest the gifts that He's already placed in you so that you might benefit the kingdom. We invite you to come. I need a rake. I need to use my rake. I need to use my hoe. I need to use my shovel. If that's you and you desire to come, we invite you now. What is the condition of your heart? I hear the Bible said, if God would mark iniquity, who could stand? Have you allowed leaves to accumulate in your heart? Come rake them out. Have you allowed rocks to form in your heart? Come hold them out. Have you allowed unclean deposits to be deposited in your heart? Get the shovel and dig them out. The altar is for us. It's for us, people of God, children of God. The altar is for us. Don't be distracted. Don't let pride, false pride, keep you in your seat. God is greater than our hearts. He's greater than our hearts. God wants genuine brokenness so He can rain on us what He wants to rain on us. But He will not rain on us until the heart, the ground of our heart, is prepared, is made ready. Now maybe you're here and you have been worshiping with us for a while, and you'd like to place your membership here at this assembly. You've been worshiping. You might be a regular attender or a frequent visitor, and you say, this is the place I think that I can grow. I like the ministry here. I like the word that God sends here. I like the spirit of God that is here, and you want to affiliate yourself with this local assembly. If that's you and you're here and you make that decision, we ask you to come. I put these in this morning, so I don't think it's the battery. Now, if you need prayer for any reason at all, come now. Any reason at all, come now. Thank you. for those of you who are watching by the live stream, we invite you for the next 15 minutes. There should be a number on your screen. If you desire prayer, we have prayer counselors that will be standing by for the next 15 minutes, and we will go to the Lord with your prayer requests. So call the number that's on your screen presently. And also, we like to say that along with the number, the address of our church is on the screen. And if the Lord places on your heart to be a financial blessing to this ministry, send your tax-deductible gifts to the Home Assembly Church. Our address is 13515 South Figueroa. Zip code is 90061. And we know that the Lord will bless you. We, again, are the Apostolic Faith Home Assembly Church located in the city of Los Angeles, California. And if we live and the Lord will, we will see you next Sunday at 10 a.m. God bless you in Jesus' name.
The only truth.